Welcome to Believer's Channel. I'm Pastor Russ, and today I'm going to be talking about fear not. Before we get into that, I'd like to remind you that down below there's a thumbs up, and if you hit that, it blesses our ministry. And if you really want to bless us big time, go to that little red button, which has to do with subscribing to our channel. And every time something comes up that we do, you'll be notified. And you'll know that God's word is on the channel for you. And today I'm going to be talking about fear not. And there's a lot of fear in the world right now. And I hate to see that, because I see elderly people in the marketplace talking about how scared they are. And I see women with children talking about how scared they are. And God says, fear not. No matter what the problem, don't fear anything, because he's in control. A lot of these people don't have God. If you don't have him, then you don't have that protection. So let's get into fear not and what God really wants you to know, so you can be at ease with what's going on in the world. God's promise in Isaiah 41:10, you really want to go read it. So it tells us, so do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. He's telling us not to be worried about anything. He's telling us he's with his right hand. It's a righteous right hand. He's going to hold us in it. And he's going to take care of us. He's going to guard us. Put a hedge around us. And no matter what your problem is with income, your household, whatever it is, give it up to God. One thing I've learned is, if you have a job you don't like, but you have it because you need to make a living, and suddenly you're fired for some reason, all you have to know is God's closing a door, and he's opening up another one that's much better and might be the one you like. So whenever stuff like that happens, just brush it off by saying, well, I guess God don't want me here anymore, and he's going to open up a better place, a better door. In Timothy 1:7, it says, for God hath not given us a spirit of fear, but we have fear. So where does it come from? It comes from Satan. Satan wants you to be afraid. He wants to be able to control you. God, on the other hand, didn't give us a spirit of fear. He gave us a spirit of love. He wants us to love him. So for God hath not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and love and of sound mind. In other words, if you're not afraid, you're thinking straight. When you're afraid, you don't think so straight. Verse 9, who has saved us and called us with a holy calling, not according to our works, but according to his own purpose and grace, which was given to us in Christ Jesus, before time even began. So when you were just a spirit in heaven, you had a holy calling. God had a holy calling on you. So it didn't have anything to do with the works. We were in heaven. We weren't here doing anything. But he's got a holy calling on us. Holy callings have a lot to do with love. In Jesus, we have no reason to fear about anything. He is in control of everything. He created the world. He created the weather. He created the seasons. He created your job. He created your money. He created all things. He created you, your wife, your kids. He's the creator of all things. He created the planet and the air we breathe. The enemy of our souls loves it when we have fear, when we are afraid. Satan will do anything to get our eyes off of Savior. See, when we're afraid, our eyes ain't on Jesus. Our eyes ain't on our Lord God or Adonai. Our eyes are on our problem. Who put that problem there? Satan. They see Jesus walking on the water, and they thought he was a ghost. They cried out in fear, and Jesus said, "Be of good cheer." Now, I would have to think about that a little bit. I possibly might die within the next few seconds because of the storm I'm in, and somebody's telling me to be of good cheer. So Peter answered, "If it is you, command me to come to you." The Lord said, "Come." In other words, come on, Peter, get out on the water and walk. So Peter, having his eyes on Jesus, gets out of the boat. Waves are rocking high, and he's walking on water. His disciples were in awe. But then Peter started to look at his circumstance. He took his eyes off of Jesus. And the moment he looked at the waves, the thunder, and the lightning, he sunk. And he cried out, "Jesus, save me." And Jesus reached down and pulled him out of the water. So just like we do when we start letting the wind and waves bother us in our circumstance, we sink. And we have to cry out to Jesus, "Help me, save me." So what is it when we cry out to Jesus? It's faith. A lot of people say, "What's faith?" Well, faith is trust. It's trusting God with everything, no matter how small or how big. He will always work your problem out for good. You know, we have a tendency to want to microwave God. And just because we pray right now doesn't mean it's going to happen this second. I was always bad at that. I was always complaining to God. I was always saying, "Well, we're supposed to be doing things even greater than Jesus, but I don't see it." See, I never seen it. People are supposed to be getting healed on the spot. I don't see it. Well, when I died in the hospital, Jesus came to me and he taught me. He answered my prayers and taught me. He said, "I do things my way, my time. And when I do something, it's to glorify God." I had to go through some stuff to glorify God. When I was in hospital, I didn't say anything about, "Oh, I'm not worried. God will heal me." Well, you know, I didn't say anything like that because, hey, if God didn't, then God would look like a fool. And I didn't want to do that. So I didn't say anything. I decided I want the doctors to tell me. And when it was all over, I mean, they took my heart out, they rebuilt it, stuck it back in, I died twice. When it was all over, the doctors came to me and said, "You're a miracle." See, when I first went in the hospital, they gave me till nightfall. Then I was still around. So they went ahead and operated 3 days later, and when I went in, I had 12% of my heart working. But they operated, and as I was going in, they were telling my family I wasn't going to come out. So here I am. But all them doctors had to say, "You're a miracle." And the nursing staff, remember this one male nurse said to me, "We were all betting it would take a year for you to heal up." And he said, 3 days later, "We were having a hard time keeping you abed. We all say you're a miracle." Where's miracles come from? God. All of them had to admit that God had his hand in that. A year and a half later, I was in the hospital, a different one, and my appendix split. And they gave me a 50-50 chance. What was weird, I had no pain. When I went in, there was no pain. I had a big lump on my side, didn't know why. That's why I went in. And the doctors couldn't figure out why I didn't crawl through the door. And told them I didn't have no pain. So that took a couple weeks to straighten out. Again, they gave me a 50-50 chance. God was there. But when they all looked at my history, they came back and said, "You shouldn't even be here. You're a miracle." And five doctors in that emergency room. Said you're a miracle. So, God asked me here to preach to you, to bring you the good word, to tell you to trust him, like he impressed on me. I do it my way. I do it my time. And his way and his time is the best way, because it ends up glorifying God. I had to go through a lot of stuff to glorify God. Jesus went through a lot of stuff to glorify God. But faith is just trusting. Trust God. And I'm asking you to pray after me today. Just give your life to Jesus. And if you have already done that, just do it again. Renew it. Say, "Father God, I'm a sinner, but I believe what Jesus did for me will save me. I believe his blood will wash me clean. And I'm asking right now that you forgive me and that you guide me, make it possible for me to have tremendous faith. I just ask this in Yeshua Jesus' name. Amen." You said that prayer, all the bad stuff's behind you. And everything's good. Everything that's good is in front of you. May God bless you. May he keep you. And may his face shine upon you. In Yeshua Jesus' name. Amen.